हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ELS इंग्लिश लिटरेचर स्टडीज विद कोर हटवे। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द स्पेक्टेटर एंड द टैटलर इन डिटेल। इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियोस आई हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट पीरियडिकल एसेस, लिंक विल बी गिवन इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स, एंड अलोंग विद दैट आई हैव डिस्कस्ड प्रोज राइटर्स ऑफ 18th सेंचुरी। यू कैन ऑल्सो चेक दोज वीडियोज। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट दीज पीरियडिकल्स, एंड दीज टू पीरियडिकल्स बिकेम पॉपुलर। दीज टू पीरियडिकल्स द स्पेक्टेटर एंड द टैटलर became popular because they showed interest for the trading class. Most of the traders were Whigs and landed gentry or nobles or Tories, and the clash between two parties was not only political but we can say social also. In the Spectator, Addison showed praise for the trading community, much to their gratification. Up to that, the period writers had presented their dishonesty, meanness, calculating nature sarcastically. And if we talk about the style of these essays were written very simple, conversational, clear, as to be easily understood and appreciated by the semi-educated or unscholarly reader. Women appreciated such clear and simple style, and they made a large population of readers. And what about these two we can say periodicals? I will discuss in detail with the help of these slides. These are the notes. You can also take out its photostat copies, or you can also note down. That is why I'm giving the notes in written form. So let us start with today's video. The Tatler, 1709 to 1711. The first magazine to be published was the Tatler in 1709 by Richard Steele. This magazine talked about both news and gossip. Anybody could have all the gossip and news in one place and available for everyone. These all were reported and issued from various London coffee houses and chocolate houses. In the beginning, it was appearing 3 times a week. No charges for them, but after some time, he asked for a penny. Richard Steele used the persona of Bickerstaff, a fictional character originally contrived by Swift, and he created a fictional frame for Bickerstaff. This imaginary figure was well known in England and especially in London, and thus this first observer of contemporary society was in a certain sense trustworthy. 2 months after the Tatler ceased publication, Joseph Addison and Steele launched the brilliant periodical The Spectator. Addison had come to play an increasingly important role to an end. It was published for 2 years. It represented a new approach to journalism. Later on, several journals revived this, The Tatler. The Female Tatler by Mrs. Cranthorpe, this is pen name. The magazine ran for less than a year. Then we have The Tatler. This is a daily journal of literature, and the stage by Leigh Hunt. Then again, Tatler by Clement Shorter. Richard's style was simple, and the main purpose of him was to teach his people how to behave in a formal situation, how to carry out a conversation, how to dress accordingly to their status, etc. Because this was a new class at the time. 2 months after quitting the Tatler, Steele and Addison began writing The Spectator. According to Richard Steele, the general purpose of this paper is to expose false arts of life, to pull off the disguises of the cunning, and recommended a general simplicity in our dress, our discourse, and our behavior. And the chief importance we can say of this periodical, The Tatler, lies in its social and moral criticism. So friends, this was about The Tatler. Next is The Spectator. The age in which Joseph Addison wrote The Spectator was called the New Classical Age of Literature. This was also termed as Augustan Age, and this is the age which witnessed the marvelous development of art, literature, science, and philosophy. Writers of this age wanted their age to mark great progress in all fields of learning and art, and we can say it is better to call this age an age of prose and reason, and this age saw great development of prose, the medium of reason. The emphasis was on reason, and rationality was the outcome of reaction against romanticism. Addison and Steele absorbed the spirit of the age, and this age was most suitable for the rise of the periodical essay. They realized opposite points of view and moral standards prevailing within the society, and they realized the importance of the middle class, which wanted the culture and refinement of the higher class, but this class was not willing to compromise its own moral codes. These essays actually inspired the reader The Art of Gentle Living. Edison gave the message of refinement and simplicity to the prevailing age of coarseness and artificiality. Through these essays, he attacks all the little vanities and all big vices of his time, not in the manner of Swift, which makes a reader feel hopeless, but with a kind ridicule and gentle humor which takes speedy improvement for granted. The Spectator was probably a true picture of his own personality. After studying at the university, he moves to London and there notes all the phases of life which he experienced. Edison is more delightful in illustrating the contrast between the country and the town life, the clash of rural feudalism with urban manners. Johnson says, "Whosoever wishes to attain an English style, familiar but not coarse and elegant but not ostentatious, must give his days and nights to the volumes of Edison." These essays are remarkable in style. They show growing perfection of English language. They give us characters that live forever as part of that lovely company. Steele and Edison were the writers who set an example for their successors. They not only introduced the modern essay, but they heralded the dawn of modern novel. Friends, listen here. I think my language is very simple and very clear to all of you. And I hope you can understand what I'm saying. I don't think that I need more explanation. I don't need to elongate my sentences. So I hope you are understanding, because I'm getting messages that they want explanation. They want me to explain in Hindi, but I don't think it is good to do MA English or study MA literature in Hindi. So I try my best to give you simple language that is easy to understand. I have no more to give you explanation, right? So hoping for the best, let us continue. They not only introduced a modern essay, but they heralded the dawn of modern novel. The magazine became so popular that it had imitations in other countries like in Germany and France. Edison's style was sophisticated and precise. He was also very good in describing his characters. He was also able to understand inner qualities and relationships. The aims of the Spectator was to eliminate morality with wit and to temper wit with morality. Also, another aim of the Spectator was to bring philosophy out of the closets and libraries and schools and colleges to dwell in clubs and assemblies. It was the best paper concerning morals, manners, thoughts and ideas of English society of the age of Queen Anne. The Guardian was a short-lived newspaper which published in London, and it was founded by Richard Steele with contributions from Joseph Edison. The popularity of the Tatler and the Spectator prompted many imitations, for instance, which I've already discussed. The best was Steele's The Guardian. It was daily like the Spectator. The importance of the periodical essays diminished because Edison became busy with his tragedy. And the second reason is its open indulgence in political affairs. So friends, with this, I would like to end my lecture here. I hope you will like my content. And if you like it, please hit the like button, share and subscribe my channel. And if you are new to my channel, please hit the bell button so that you can get notifications for my upcoming videos. And thanks a lot for watching. And you can also, you have my ebooks available on Kindle and Amazon. And thanks a lot for watching.